Hey kids, I'm Space Cadet Thomas, and I'm an astronaut for NASA. I'm going on a top secret mission to explore the various planets of our solar system. Would you guys like to come? Follow me for some space exploration. The solar system is so big, and there's so much we can learn. I wonder what we might encounter. Oh, look, it looks like we're approaching Mars. And there's scientist Simon.
This is Mars, also known as the Red Planet, and it is a terrestrial planet. Mars is the fourth planet away from the Sun and the second smallest in our solar system. Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars are the closest planets to the Sun and are classified as the inner four. Terrestrial planets are mostly made up of silicate rocks and metals. Good luck on the rest of your journey, Space Cadet Thomas.
Wow. Mars and the terrestrial planets are so fascinating because they are so similar to the Earth. I wonder what we might encounter next. Would you look at that? It's Saturn! And there's scientist Becky. Let's see what she has to say.
Hello, hop on the rings of Saturn with me. Jupiter and Saturn are considered the gas planets. While this ring planet may have a small rocky core, it's still the second largest planet in our solar system. The ice planets are considered gas planets since they have hydrogen and helium present as well. Saturn has thousands of rings composed of small chunks of ice and rock. Okay. I can't wait to see what you find next on your space journey, Space Cadet Thomas. Good luck!
Wow! Those planets were huge! I'm so glad that scientist Becky was there to share them with us. It's getting chilly. We must be approaching the ice planets. And look, there's scientist Sharon now.
Welcome to Uranus. This planet is referred to as the ice giant. Neptune is also under the categorization of an ice planet. Neptune is the seventh planet from the Sun and is the coldest planet in our solar system. It has 13 rings and is composed of the elements hydrogen and helium. It takes 84.3 Earth years to orbit around the Sun. Well, Space Cadet Thomas, I hope you enjoyed this really cold planet. Hope you find somewhere warmer to go next.
Wow, those planets sure were cold. Good thing I attended Washington State University, so I'm accustomed to those harsh winters. Wow, that was a long flight. It sure is getting bright out. We must be getting close to the Sun. And look, there's scientist Elizabeth right over there.
Welcome to the Sun, the light of your life. Don't come too close, you wouldn't want to burn yourself. The temperature on the surface is 5,778 degrees Kelvin, which is roughly 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Not only is it extremely hot, but I'm much larger than I seem. However, I'm actually only a medium-sized star. There are many stars in the solar system, but none near us. Hope you enjoyed your trip, kids. Over and out, Space Cadets.
Jeepers! That was quite the trip around the solar system. Before we go back to Earth, though, let's review some of the many things we've learned.
Remember, kids, Mars is the fourth planet away from the Sun and is also called the Red Planet for its rock color.
Scientist Becky here with the good facts. Did you know that Saturn has thousands of rings composed of ice and rock, and it's also the second largest planet in our solar system?
Remember, Uranus is the ice giant, and it takes 84.3 years for it to orbit the Sun.
When you're on Earth, the Sun looks pretty small, but it's actually a medium-sized star. And remember, it's the source of life in our solar system.
And now it's time to head back to Earth. I had so much fun learning about the solar system with you guys today. Take it away, Teach. Looks like we're approaching Saturn. I was trying to think of a name. Now, okay.
Remember, kids. What is it, Mars?
Mars.
We're going back to the...